Hi, and welcome to 4 Minute Answers, the place to get quick answers to your important questions. And in this video, we'll show you how to create a shopping list that talks to your recipes in Notion. Notion is a powerful organization tool that we use to organize our work and life, and we have a series of quick Notion videos designed to take you from novice to pro. So subscribe to 4 Minute Answers, and when you do, leave a comment below that says you're a new subscriber, and we'll say hi, and press the thumbs up on this video too. So let's get to it. In our last video, we showed you how you can easily create a gallery database, and we gave you this example of how to do it for recipes. Now, if you need a refresher, you can watch the video, and we have a link below. One of the great things about Notion, though, is that you can get areas of Notion to talk to each other seamlessly, but you need to think about how to set it up first. Now that we've created this recipe database here in gallery mode, I want to be able to open up a recipe, and as I'm looking at it, tick off the items that I need to pick up at the store when I am there. So let's make that happen. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to create a shopping list database. So we go down on the left navigation, we click on add a page, and we do shopping list. Now we have a video on how to create a simple database if you want to get a refresher on that, but you hit backslash, and now we're going to pick inline table. And here you would do a simple database of what you need. Now, I'm going to jump here to one that we've already created where we have item, whether we need it as a shopping list, and this is just a checkbox, yes or no, an amount, and then the recipe title so that we know what dish it's for, just in case we change our mind when we're at the store. All right, so that's all you need in your shopping list. And so now, when you go to your favorite recipe and you go to set it up, well, normally, let's look at the potato leek soup. Normally, you would just list the ingredients like this. However, that's not going to talk to your shopping list. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to create a linked database. And we've done this in previous videos. Backslash, create a linked database. All the way down here. And now it's going to ask us to find the database. And we're going to find the one that is shopping list. Right here. So when you do this, it's going to bring up everything in your shopping list. And of course, that's not really useful, but we're going to filter out anything that is not this recipe, which is this recipe is called potato leek soup. And as you can see, now the only thing in there is potatoes. There's nothing else in there. And I can now add my items. So I want 1 1/2 cups of cream. Do I need it? Maybe I do, maybe I don't. I'll see I don't. And then I just keep going on. I add each of the items. And then I tick off the ones that I want. So let's just note that we put potatoes and cream in here as items that we need. Now when we go back to our shopping list, let's look to see if we have potatoes and cream connected to our potato leek soup. Here they are. So it's happened. And so now when we go to the store, we can pull up Notion on our mobile app, pull up the shopping list, and as we pick things off at the grocery store, we can just tick them off and they disappear. Now they don't disappear from the recipes. They still appear on your recipes. And frankly, this is just filtering the shopping list out. So it only shows items that have a check mark. Right, so we have it filtered so where the shopping list is a check mark. And so that way we know exactly what it is that we need. So I hope this is helpful. One other thing that you're going to want to consider doing is here in your favorite recipe section, you're going to want to create an item, a recipe, if you will, for pantry items, things like coffee or paper towels, anything like that that doesn't really fit into a recipe, but you want to make sure that you get at the store. So here is where you can put that list, click yes, and then it appears on your shopping list. So now you've learned about gallery databases, creating a recipe database, and connecting it to a shopping list that makes it easy for you to organize your life as you go to the store. If you have questions or comments about this or any other aspect of Notion, add it in the comments below, and be sure to check out our other 4 Minute Answer videos to help you become a Notion pro quickly. Thanks, and we'll see you soon.